The Constitution provides that in all criminal prosecutions, the accused shall be presumed innocent until the contrary is proved. The burden of proof is on the prosecution. How much proof is necessary? In other words, what is the standard of proof? I have adopted the very high standard of overwhelming preponderance of evidence pursuant to the recommendation of Professor Charles Black of Yale University, author of The Impeachment, considered the Bible for the whole world on impeachment process in a democracy. My standard is very high because removal by conviction on impeachment is a stunning penalty, the ruin of a life. The defendant admitted that he did not declare his dollar accounts and certain commingled peso accounts in his sal N. Let us begin with this threshold question. Did this omission amount to an impeachable offense? No. Under the rule of jus generis, when a general word occurs after a number of specific words, the meaning of the general word shall be limited to the kind or class of thing within which the specific words fall. The Constitution provides that the impeachable offenses are culpable violation of the Constitution, treason, bribery, graft and corruption, other high crimes, or betrayal of public trust. An omission in good faith in the sal N carries a light penalty and is even allowed by law to be corrected by the person who submitted it. Thus, it is not impeachable because it is not in the same class as the offenses enumerated in the Constitution. If we disregard this rule of jus generis, then we can interpret the law to mean anything as long as the enumeration of specific words is followed by a general word. Wala nang limitasyon yon. Pag sinabi pala ng Constitution, other high crimes or betrayal of public trust, wala na palang limitasyon yon. Iyan, kung hindi ka nag-aaral ng batas. Sabi ng batas, you apply the rule of jus generis. Kailangan may listahan na isa-isa nilang sinasabi kung anong kasalanan at merong isang salita na hindi mo malamit kung anong kasalanan, dapat basahin mo iyan na pare-pareho doon sa kasalanan na nalista na. In other words, it should belong to the same class. Does omission in the sal N belong to the same class as, for example, treason, bribery, etc.? The Constitution simply provides that a public officer shall submit a declaration under oath of his assets, liabilities, and net worth. I am quoting the Constitution. That is all. There are no details. The Constitution is a brief declaration of fundamental principles. Many constitutional provisions are only commands to the Congress to enact laws to carry out the purpose of the Charter. As a general rule, constitutional provisions are not self-executory. Hindi naman pwede na basahin mong Constitution na para ka bang nagbasa ng dyaryo, tapos kanya-kanya kayong interpretasyon. Hindi ganun yun. Kaya nga meron tayong constitutional law, which is said to be the most difficult subject to pass in the entire College of Law. Hindi ganun kadali magbasa ng Constitution. Constitutional analysis is a field of art in itself. It is a technical field. Kaya apat na taon ang abogasiya. Eh kung baska sino lang pala pwedeng mag-interpret ng Constitution, bakit pa tayo may mga abogado? Di kanya-kanya na lang. The usual exceptions are the Bill of Rights, yan, self-executory yan, basahin mo, sundin mo. And constitutional provisions, pag sinabi ng batas, hindi pwede ito, yan, sundin mo kaagad. Pero lahat, hindi mo pwedeng masunod kaagad-agad. Mag-antay ka kung anong batas ang ipapasa ng Kongreso. Wala kaming ginagawa sa Kongreso kung hindi mag-antay kung anong sinabi ng Constitution. That is the main function of legislation. All other constitutional provisions, such as the sound provision, need implementing laws to provide the details. Hence, Congress, to implement this constitutional provision, has passed a number of laws, including the Foreign Currency Act, which confers absolute confidentiality on dollar deposits. Nakikinig la ako doon, noon, sa mga argumento na the Foreign Currency Act violates the Constitution. I was already hoping with all my heart that God would strike me dead.
Mabuti pang mamatay ako bilang isang abogada nang sa makikinig ako ng mga rason na ganon. Wala yan sa libro, wala yan dito, wala yan doon. Para bang hindi ka nagbasa ng batas mo. Di ibig mo sabihin, wala na palang batas na nag-iiral sa mga trial na ito. Kundi kanya-kanya ng isipan. There is no conflict between the Constitution and the Foreign Currency Act. The perceived conflict is so simplistic that it is seriously laughable. Nakakatawa ka o nagpapatawa ka. If there is any conflict, it is between the Code of Conduct and Ethical Standards on the one hand, which provides for a waiver of confidentiality, and the Foreign Currency Act on the other hand, which provides for absolute confidentiality. Kaya sinusunod natin ang batas sa Constitution, pero ang batas na pinairal ng Kongreso mukhang may conflict. Pero hindi mo masabi na the Constitution is clear, so the Constitution will of course prevail over an ordinary law. Ano namang klaseng kagaguhan yan? Galit kayo dahil ginamit ko ang salita na kagaguhan? I repeat, kagaguhan yan. Why do you study law if that is your opinion? At bakit matawagin na quasi-judicial itong proceedings na ito? If it's all purely political and anyone can have his own opinion. It is for Congress to balance on the one hand the need for public accountability from public officers with, on the other hand, the desperate need for foreign investment, which entails confidentiality on pain of driving away investors from our country. Yan ang rason kung bakit meron tayong Foreign Currency Deposit Act. Dahil gusto natin na paratingin ang foreign investment at walang foreign investor. I promise you, na darating kung merong bayan na may batas pala na lahat ng dolyar mo, ideklara mo. Walang darating maski isa. That is the purpose of that law. Did anybody of you bother to find out why we have a Currency Deposit Act? Puro lang tingin ninyo tungkol sa impeachment. I-parking mong pera mo dyan. Ah, mamaya. Isasalungat ko yung mga argumento ninyong yan. It makes me angry. As a former law professor and as a future judge of the International Criminal Court, that you should presume to administer justice in this manner. I am insulted by the way your minds run. It is for Congress. The argument that a dollar deposit protected from inquiry would nullify the principle of transparency is for Congress to resolve. Ay di tayo! Kayo sa House at kami sa Senate, tayo ang gumawa niyan, tayo ngayon ang may problema. Dibigyan natin ng solusyon ang problema. We could retain the absolute confidentiality clause with the amendment that Filipino public officers are not protected. Yun ang dapat gagawin natin. The prosecution mistakes admission for confession. In law, in a confession, the defendant admits his guilt. In an admission, the defendant merely states facts which might tend to prove his guilt. In the instant case, the defendant did not make a confession, but merely an admission with a legal defense. As a former RTC judge, I find it reprehensible beyond belief, that the AMLA document was introduced in evidence without authentication as required by the rules of evidence. Nagpapanggap-panggapan pa tayo na korte tayong quasi-judicial. Yun pala, sinabi pa natin na we are, if there is any need, we shall use as a supplementary authority the rules of court. Eh yun pala, hindi natin susundin ang rules of evidence. Hindi ka pwede magdala maski anong papel sa korte. I-authenticate mo. Kung hindi mo intindi kung anong authenticate, di huwag kang mag-abogado dyan. I am deeply disappointed that on at least three occasions, the prosecution claimed that his documents came from an anonymous source. Strike me dead. Three times is just too much coincidence. Are you for real prosecution? Falsus in uno, falsus in omnibus. False in one thing, false in all things. The defendant used his own name in all his question transactions. He could have done otherwise if his purpose was invisibility. Kung ayaw niyang matuklasan, kadali-dali, di gamitin niya pangalan ng iba. Lahat naman kayo, hindi naman lahat. Marami sa atin dito, kung tungkol na sa batas, ibang pangalan ang ginagamit. Sigurado ako niyan. RTC judge ako eh. Mag-isa lang akong RTC judge dito sa korteng ito. Maski ano, pwede mo manufacture sa Pilipinas. Minsan, binigyan pa nga ako ng death certificate ng kusado. Pagkatapos, minahuli ko, huling-huli, buhay na buhay. Ganon ang ating korte dito. Huwag niyo kong pandaran ng kalukuhan ninyo dahil alam na alam ko yon. Kayo, nag-practice kayo, isang taon, dalawang taon. Ako, RTC judge. Why would a suspected criminal leave his calling cards at the scene of the crime? Kung noon pa, gusto pala niyang itago ang kayamanan niya, eh bakit niya ilagay sa pangalan niya? Marami dito sa Pilipinas naglalagay sa ibang papangalan ng ibang tao. Hindi kaya alam ng abogado yon? May master's pa sa Harvard? May doctorate pa sa UST? Ganun kaya siya katanga? Assuming for the sake of argument that there is a preponderance of evidence for the prosecution, the preponderance is not overwhelming. Yan ang Ingles. Hinada ko para sa 2 minutes ko. Eh wala pala kaming limitasyon. Ngayon Tagalog naman at hingi na ako ng paumanhin, abansi pa lang dahil kulang na kulang Tagalog ko. Unang punto, kung matalo ang Chief Justice dito, di ang ibig sabihin pala, ang mga nananalo ay mga honest na tao dahil kinundina nila dahil corrupt yung taong yon. Di, palagay din natin na itong mga representante, dahil lahat tayo, we represent the people, isn't that so? That's why we are elected officers. We're supposed to represent our constituencies. Eh kung hatulan natin may sala yan, di, ibig lang sa, dahil crooked siya, di ibig lang sabihin tayo, honest tayo. Ngayon, kung lahat pala tayo honest, o marami pala tayo sa atin ay honest, why is the Philippines often, or if not all the time, why is the Philippines always ranked as one of the most corrupt countries in the whole world? Yan, sagutin niyo ako niyan. Nagpapakalinis kayo? Aba kung malinis pala ang mga opisyalis natin at malinis pala sa buong bansa, eh bakit palagi tayong nililista ng Transparency International as one of the most corrupt countries in the world? Magtitinginan tayo? Sino kaya dito? Yan ang unang punto ko. Pangalawa, tumigil na kayo ng kapapanggap-panggapan nyo, mga artista. Merong mga politiko na alam natin kung anong loopholes nila sa SALN. Deposito ang sinasabi ng batas pagkatapusan ng Disyembre, katapusan ng taon. Magdeklara ka kung magkanong pera mo sa bangko. Hindi ba gini-withdraw nila pera nila sa buwan na Nobyembre o Disyembre? Para pag naglagay sila, pag nag-file sila ng SALN nila, wala nga silang deposito. O kaya meron lang sila ng couple of thousands. Kasi minidraw nila eh. Pag Enero, i-deposit nila uli. Taong bayan, kayo ang magtestigo. Yan. Ba't hindi natin habulin yung ganon? Pangalawa, palusot. O pangalawa, na ginagawa nila na loophole sa SALN. Lahat ng pag-ari nila, real estate, bank accounts, iba pang pag-ari, nilalagay sa ibang pangalan. Yan is very, very widespread. O di wala nga naman silang pag-ari dahil lahat, linagay na nila sa ibang pangalan. Kung bawal ang asawa at ang mga anak dahil sa batas ay inspeksyonin pati iyan, yung mga malapit sa kanila. Di doon sa mga malalayo ng mga kamag-anak. O kaya maski hindi kamag-anak, sa kaibigan na pinagkakatiwalaan nila. What a hypocritical accusation. That is a problem with this country. We're all for honest government, and yet the world condemns us as one of the most corrupt countries in the world. That's why it is difficult to win in any international election, in any international campaign, because the Philippines, among others, has a reputation of being a corrupt country. Isip ng iba, kung corrupt ang bayan na yan, walang matinong lalabas dyan. Walang matinong ibubunga yan. Bawat isa ba sa inyo, walang sala tungkol sa SALN? Bigyan nyo ako ng isa pang buhay. Panginoon, bigyan mo ako ng isa pang buhay at imbestigahin ko lahat, isa-isa. dito sa Senado at sa House of Representatives. Tignan natin. Pati sarili ko, imbestigahin ko.
Order, please.
Ang daming loopholes ng sal. Eh na yan, ba't hindi kayong umimik noon? Ba't ngayon bigla na lang kayong so exercised about a loophole? Well, if that is the case, then let us all just put our assets in dollars and know the purpose of the sal and will be perverted or corrupted. That is true. But what about all the other loopholes? Bakit ngayon lang kayo nagalit tungkol sa loophole na yan? Bakit doon pa? Dahil yung iba sa atin, ginagamit yung mismong loopholes na yon. Hindi lang sila ma-impeach. Sunod na punto. Sinabi ko sa umpisa, this is quasi-judicial and this is quasi-political. Yan aminado yan ng mga authors. Si Professor Charles Black ng Yale, si Professor Raoul Berger ng Harvard. Mga tinitingala yan ng mga authorities all over the world. Ngayon, this is quasi-judicial. Ibig sabihin, kalahati niyan politika. Kalahati yan batas. Napakahirap gawin yan. Ngayon, ako, dahil naging RTC judge, ang ginagamit ko lang ang batas. Wala akong ginagamit na pampolitika dahil hindi na ako makatakbo ulit. Natawag na ako ng International Criminal Court. Wala na akong kinabukasan sa politika sa Pilipinas. Even if I wanted to, I am prohibited because this is already my second term, consecutive term. Ngayon, ano bang sinasabi na quasi-political? Imbestigahin nga natin for future impeachments. Anong sinasabi na quasi-judicial, quasi-political? Madaling intindihin ang quasi-judicial. Kalahati niyan tungkol sa hustisya o tungkol sa batas. Pero kalahati yan tungkol sa politika. Anong ibig sabihin ng tungkol sa politika? Tungkol sa politika, dahil ang ibig sabihin dyan, pag-isipan mo at pakinggan mo ang mga taong bumoto sa iyo. That is actually the meaning of quasi-political. Because the people might disagree with what the law says. Yun ang pakikinggan mo. That is the meaning of quasi-political. Hindi ibig sabihin quasi-political na buboto ka, ulit bibigyan ka ng mamahaling proyekto sa public works na kung saan maaaring kumita ka. Alam naman natin yan. Kung magkano ang halaga ng public works mo, 10% punta sa iyo kung gusto mo. Hindi iyon ang ibig sabihin na politika. At hindi ibig sabihin na quasi-political na isipin mo, nako, tatakbo ako. Either for re-election or for another position, or I need some position in government for my kalyado ko, who I will use as my dummy. That is not the meaning of quasi-political.
May I request the lady to wind up this?
I thought that I was unlimited. I prepared a 2-minute paper, but I will obey the injunction. Tsaka, isang punto. Nang nagtapos magpresenta ng ebidensya ang prosecution, naglabas ng mga survey ng mga tao, gusto pala na guilty ang Chief Justice. Ngayon natapos ang defensa, saan ngayon ang mga survey? Wala. At huli sa lahat at pinakamahalaga, anong magiging, hindi lang importante kung anong magiging desisyon natin ngayong hapon, anong magiging katuparan o anong susunod sa ating desisyon. Ulit ba mananalo tayo sa botohan? Panalo na tayo sa masa na nakakarami sa ating bansa and we follow the rule of the majority sa kabataan, sa pamantasan dahil they're an educated constituency sa kaysaysayan ng ating bansa. This will go down in history. Nagtrabaho ako abroad. Nagka-cancer ang tatay ko. Bumalik ako. Sabi ng tatay ko, mag-resign ka nga dyan sa trabaho mong yan. Wala kang silbi sa bayan mo. Magsilbi ka sa sarili mong kababayan. Nagsilbing na nga ako. Pero kung ang politika ay mangigibabaw sa batas, wala na rin akong silbi. Bayan, kayo ang maghatol sa ginagawa dito sa impeachment trial.
What's your vote?
Would you be very surprised if I say that I vote not guilty?
Honorable Senator Judge Drilon.